Dr. Padma Iyer, President, IMA Pune. Requesting Bhagyashree Trai Patil Madam to please continue and do the honours for Dr. Madhuri Lokapurkar, Convener Muktangan 2018. Thank you, Madam. Requesting Dr. J.S. Bavalkar, Sir, Dean, Dr. D.Y. Patil Medical College, to kindly come and honor and do the felicitations for Dr. Hosi Kapadia, Sir. Thank you, one and all. Requesting Dr. J.S. Bavalkar, Sir, to kindly felicitate with a floral bouquet to Dr. Shiv Kumar Uthure, Sir. Thank you, Dean, sir. And thank you, one and all.
I now request IMA Maharashtra State President Dr. Y.S. Deshpande to give his speech.
We are moved, touched, and overwhelmed by the felicitation done by D.Y. Patil University staff, dean and officers. Dignitaries on the dais, Honorable Shri Prasad Dattaji Patil, Madam Bhagyashree Patil, Dr. Yashraj Patil, National President Dr. Ravi Vankhedkar, my friend Dean Dr. Bavalkar, Dr. Avinash Bondwe, Dr. Tandon, Dr. Monga, Dr. Padma Iyer, and all my friends sitting on the dais, and the distinguished delegates who have come from all parts of the country who are there in the audience, as well as the staff of this college, and my dear students. The hospitality which we are enjoying for last 2 days, since yesterday we were here, and I would tell you that myself, Dr. Ravi Vankhedkar, we were here till 8 o'clock in the night, and all of them, they were here actively working. Even office staff was also there, and we place on record, they have not left any stone unturned for making arrangements for this cultural fest. So big round of applause for the dean, staff, P.D. Patil sir, and dear students. In fact, this cultural fest is indeed a brainchild of Dr. Ravi Vankhedkar. I would tell you, all of us get a lot of ideas, lot of creative ideas are there, but then it is not possible to implement them. The cultural fest to come into the mind and implement it, I mean, it is a great thing which a person like Dr. Ravi Vankhedkar can only do it. There are other projects also which were there, which practically we thought they were impossible to implement. But then he has seen to it that a lot of new ideas, a lot of new things which he has implemented this year, may it be awareness of sexual health or vitiligo awareness, or so many things are there. And throughout the year, he worked so well that his tenure is going to be a landmark tenure. And I have no hesitation to say that it will be very difficult for a coming president, because the height which he has reached and the level of competence he has achieved, it will be very difficult for the coming team. But I am sure Dr. Ravi Vankhedkar would continue to guide them and will continue to work for IMA. There are a lot of historical other events also which were there in his tenure. Dr. Ravi sir, IMA Maharashtra is grateful to you for giving us opportunity to host this maiden festival in our state of Maharashtra. And Pune was rightly chosen for this particular festival, being a cultural capital not only of Maharashtra, but it is of the national, it is of country also, cultural capital of India. And that Dr. Avinash has rightly said that indeed they have proved that, may it be a musical section, painting, and so many other things which are indeed excellent, and a lot of efforts have been put by all those who are participating in this. Now, India is known for its cultural diversity. Culture is important for understanding the human behavior. Cultural background can have major influence on our behavior and thinking, and also quality of life which we enjoy. Culture should be vibrant and it should not be stagnant. The various ideas which were implemented in this fest, like Book Dindi or the mural paintings and the exhibition of all that, everything was extremely interesting, and all of us, we have enjoyed tremendously, and I am sure the memories of which would linger for years and years together. And as rightly said, this is the first maiden festival, but henceforth this would again continue, and IMA delegates, IMA members who have got hidden talents would get opportunity to exhibit their art, their talents in the coming festivals. Thank you, Meenakshi, and this thing for using all good words for us. And most important is the audience which is there in large number. So I have two lines for them. Na hote aap, to ye sham itni rangeen katahi nahi hoti. Aap hi se hamari hasti hai, varna ye bahar haseen nahi hoti. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Deshpande. I now invite our president, Dr. Padma Iyer, Madam, for doing the honors of felicitations. IMA Pune is thankful to many, many people who have donated as well as who have given, contributed to this function. I request Dr. Padma Iyer, Madam, to felicitate Chancellor of D.Y. Patil Medical College and Vidyapeeth, Dr. P.D. Patil. I request her to felicitate our national president, Dr. Ravi Wankhedkar, sir. I also request her to felicitate Mrs. Bhagyashree Patil, Vice Chairman of D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth. Dr. Somnath Patil, Secretary of Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth. Dr. Yashiraj Patil, Treasurer of Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth. I now request our convener, Dr. Avinash Bhondwe, to come forward to felicitate Dr. N.J. Pawar, Director Academics of D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth. Dr. N.J. Pawar. Dr. A. N. Suryakar, Registrar of D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth. Dr. R. N. Tandon, Honorary Secretary General, National IMA. Dr. V. K. Monga, Honorary Finance Secretary, National IMA. Dr. J.S. Bhavalkar, Dean of D.Y. Patil Medical College. I now request Dr. Sanjay Patil, Vice President of Pune IMA and Organizing Secretary of Muktangan, to felicitate Dr. Y.S. Deshpande, Maharashtra State IMA President. Dr. Parthiv Sanghvi, Secretary of IMA Maharashtra State. And Dr. Shivkumar Uttire, President of Maharashtra Medical Council. Thank you, sir, for doing the honors. I now invite Dr. Ratna Nevar to introduce Dr. P.D. Patil, our guest of honor.
Good evening, one and all. A very big Hercules task given to me. Words are less to introduce Honorable Dr. Prasad Dattaji Rao Patil, Chancellor Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth Pimpri Pune, who is a real visionary and who made the excellence in field of professional education, not only at the national level, but internationally too. He is a pioneer in providing world-class medical education to the students from India and abroad. Relentlessly worked for the upliftment of man-machine interface to provide healthcare at affordable cost to patients, and even known for his charitable healthcare delivery to poor of the poorest, sick and needy human beings. This time will be too less to count the millions of achievements our Honorable Chancellor has done. as you all must be eager to hear words of wisdom straight from him. So inviting Honorable Chancellor, Dr. D.Y. Patil, Medical College, Vidyapeeth, and all the institutions, heartthrob, P.D. Patil, sir, to address the national gathering. Sir, please come up to the dais.
Good evening. Dear Dr. Wankhedkar, National President, IMA Headquarters, Delhi, Dr. R.N. Tandon, Secretary General, IMA Headquarters, Dr. Munga, Treasurer, IMA Headquarters, Dr. Y.S. Deshpande, President, IMA Maharashtra State, Padma Shri, Dr. Marthan Pillai, Dr. Padma Iyer, President, IMA Pune, Dr. Sanjay Patil, Organizing Secretary, Dr. Avinash Bhondwaje, and Dr. Madhuri Lokapur, Convener of this conference, Dr. Aarti and Dr. Nimba from IMA Pune, Dr. Shiv Kumar Utture, Chairman MMC, Shri Shantanu Sen, Member of Parliament Rajya Sabha, Mrs. Bhagyashri Patil, Vice Chairman Dr. D.Y. Patil, Vidyapeeth, Dr. Bhavalkar, Dean Dr. D.Y. Patil Medical College, officials and members of the IMA, headquarters Delhi, Maharashtra, and other states of India, all delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It is a matter of great honor and pleasure to welcome you all and host this first of its kind IMA conference. Dr. Ravi Wankhedkar, sir, and his team, they have given us the opportunity to conduct this conference, Muktangan 2018, that is Sahitya Kala Sammelan. Sir, thank you very much. You have given us the opportunity. The IMA has been an umbrella organization that's played a stellar role in representing the medical fraternity. It has been of immense value to serve as a vital link between the policymakers and the medical community. IMA has time and again provided timely and vital services in the face of natural calamities. I was deeply touched by their noble gesture of contributing even financially towards the welfare of the victims of the recent Kerala floods. My proximity to medical students, doctors, specialists, and super specialists has given me the opportunity to get a very clear understanding of these highly respected, hardworking, and yet often misunderstood segment of the society. In this age and era of increasing awareness and accountability, there has been a spate of litigations against doctors. They are no longer looked upon as a divine blessings, divine beings with healing powers. They have been reduced to services that can be purchased and held responsible for outcomes that sometimes are beyond their control. The significance and importance of the IMA has increased tremendously in light of these changed circumstances. Newer policies, rules, and regulations have also made it progressively difficult for doctors to start practice. There is an increasing tendency towards favoring corporate hospitals. I do hope that IMA and its office bearers will always provide support and guidance to the medical professionals to deal with this changing scenario. This gathering, the first of its kind, has been conceived with the objective of providing platform for the members to step up, step out of their professional organization, professional obligations and discussions, and spend time to relax and let their hair down. Most often, doctors get together for a conference or a seminar where academic discussions and professionals' issues dominate the proceedings. I invite and appeal to all the members of the medical fraternity to use this opportunity to take a break, keeping aside the stresses and tensions of their profession, and enjoy the various programs by participating and appreciating the talents of your colleagues. The medical profession has been and will be the noblest of professionals. It needs constant upgradation of knowledge and latest advances. The frontiers of medicine are being pushed forward almost every week, every few weeks. Technology, cutting-edge research, development of new molecules and interventions has had a profound impact on this rapidly evolving domain of medicine. The onslaught of information technology has revolutionized medical education too. Our attempts to keep abreast with all their emerging modalities, the Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth Pune has ensured a high NAC ranking with CGPA score of 3.62, and we are ranked 18th nationally in the medical institute category by the latest ranking issued by NRF. To this effect, we were the first medical college in India to install a fourth generation state-of-the-art Da Vinci robot with the console for the students' learning. This is priceless for both therapeutic and training of PG students. We also have the most modern imaging